Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's talk about using multiple calendars. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you can use the calendar app on your Mac, your iPad, and your iPhone to keep track of events, appointments, meetings, all sorts of things. But a lot of people put all of that into one calendar, or maybe break it up into two. But there's no reason you can't have lots of different calendars, and doing so gives you some advantages. So here in the calendar app, I've got two calendars, one called Work, one called Personal. It's pretty straightforward, but there's no reason to just have two. You can have as many calendars as you like. And sometimes it makes sense to have more calendars because you can easily switch them on and off. For instance, I could add a new event here. I use the plus button here to do that, and I'll say meeting on Friday at 10. And it'll add that for next Friday, and I can customize it here. And it puts it in the calendar that I have selected. But there's no reason I can't have a special calendar just for meetings. So I could go to File, New Calendar, and it's going to create it under the account I'm currently using. So in this case, iCloud. And I could put Meetings. And I can move this event to it. Moving an event from calendar to calendar is easy. One way to do it is to control click on it, select calendar, and then switch to another one. But you could also double click on it to bring it up and then use this pull down menu here to switch. Another way to do it is simply to drag and drop it onto a calendar and it will switch the calendar that it's using. Now the advantage to having all my meetings in a separate calendar is I could easily switch them on or off. So I could have it separate from other things I do for work. Maybe work tasks. Maybe I wouldn't even have a general work calendar, but have things specific to different projects I'm working on, different groups I work with. You can easily have them all switched on and see them just like they were in the same calendar. But one advantage is they'll have different colors for the dots next to them. If you control click on a calendar and choose Get Info, you can change its name, add a description which will appear here again so that could help clarify things for you if you want to add some notes about why this calendar exists. You could also change the color. You can pick from specific colors, but you can also choose other and then use the color wheel here or any part of the color picker to choose any color you want for that calendar. So for instance, you can range all of your work related calendars from yellow to red to orange and have personal things be more blues and purples. It's perfectly okay to have 3 or 10 or 20 different calendars and switch them on or off to make things more clear on your calendar. Here, this is pretty empty. It's just my demo calendar. But a lot of us have a very crowded calendar, lots of things. So having different categories for different parts of work, personal life, travel, get-togethers, reminders for things, all in different calendars can really help organize it and you could focus on one thing at a time. And of course, you'll be able to see all of these on your iPad and iPhone as well because here I'm using these calendars under iCloud. Now another advantage of having multiple calendars is sharing them. You don't want to share all of your work events or all of your personal events. So you could go and create a new calendar here. Let's call this one Family. And then I can click on the Share button next to it. Share it with members of my family. And they would see things in here. You can have multiple shared calendars shared with your family. So things like vacation plans or even if you have a calendar for your work travel, you can make that a shared calendar and share it with your spouse so they know when you're traveling, they know where you're staying, they know your flights and all of that. But that could be separate from meetings and work tasks that you don't need to share with anybody else. You can also, of course, share with different services. So it's okay to have iCloud calendars here. But if you go to Calendar Preferences, you could see under Accounts here, I have an iCloud account, of course, my Apple ID associated with this. But I also have a Google account here. And if I enable this account for calendars, it will then appear here on the left. And I can have Google calendars and they can appear side by side here with my iCloud calendars. There's really no difference. So if I select this one here and let's say I add an event here, that's in my Google calendar. So I can turn that on or off. Now the advantage of doing that is if you have a coworker or family member that isn't in the Apple ecosystem, they instead are using Android or Windows and they have a Google calendar, not an iCloud calendar, you could just as easily have that shared between you. So you can have your iCloud calendars and your Google calendars all shown at the same time and use the checkboxes to determine which ones are being shown at any given time. Now, if you create a bunch of calendars and decide you don't need some of them, but you don't want to delete them, you can merge them with an existing calendar or with each other. So you can go here under Edit, Merge Calendar, and you can see you can merge another calendar with the one you have selected. So I can merge my meetings calendar with work this way. And I can continue to merge calendars down. So for instance, say you start a calendar when you start a new project at work, and when you're done with that project, you could have an old projects calendar. And then you could merge that project into the old projects calendar to keep all the events and information around without having all of these calendars that you're not using anymore sticking around. You can also select a calendar that you don't want anymore. And before you delete it, you can go to File, Export, and export it in one of two formats. Using Export gives you the standard calendar format. So you can save that out, put it as a file somewhere, and then delete it from calendar. And you've got kind of this backup of it if you ever need to refer to it. So I hope this gives you some ideas about how to better use the Calendars app on your Mac, your iPad, and your iPhone. Definitely set up multiple calendars. If you don't like them, you can always merge them back into one calendar. But I think having multiple calendars makes it easier to organize things, to see what you need to see on the calendar at any given time. And it's just a really useful tool if you utilize it. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.